Hello and welcome to another quick edit video. This time I'm editing another waterfall picture from my Iceland trip back in 2014. So let's jump right into the editing. The very first thing I want to do is correct the colors to fit my taste. So therefore I am in the camera calibration tab, and here I'm just changing the red, green and blue primary hue. So the red one as well as the green one I will up a little bit, and then I'm reducing the blue primary hue. And you can already see the grass is getting this kind of warm orange look. Now I'm changing the white balance a little bit, so it does give my image a colder look. And then the first thing I want to do is up the shadows up to 100, and also I want to reduce the highlights. Now I also want to add some blacks, and then I want to give my image some contrast. And I might as well add a little bit of clarity, which works well with the rock formations you can see on the sides of my image. Now let's see if I can add some whites without overexposing the image. Then before I get to the color correction stuff, I want to apply some local adjustments. First I'm using a radial filter to add some glow effect in the center of my image, where the sky meets those cliffs. Basically I'm turning up the blacks, and also I'm reducing the temperature to make this area look colder. Also you'll notice with increasing the blacks I didn't overexpose the area, although it's already really bright. So if you want to add some glow, I would advise to increase the blacks instead of exposure or whites. Now I'm adding another radial filter for this glow effect in the center of my image. And again I'm increasing the blacks. Oops, I have to invert the mask first. And I also want to decrease the clarity so that it gives my image a kind of blurry look in this area. Okay, then I want to fix the bottom part of this waterfall, as it looks rather dark. Again I'm using a radial filter for that. And this time I want to increase the whites, and also I want to increase the highlights. And I'm using one last radial filter to bring out the waterfall itself. I could do this using the brush tool, but I'm honestly too lazy right now. Again, I'm increasing the whites, and I'm adding some highlights as well. Now I want to get some contrast in the grass on the left side of my image. Now, therefore, I'm using the adjustment brush and just roughly paint over this area. And what I'm doing here is I'm adding a lot of contrast and also a lot of clarity. Okay, that looks better, but I'm still not satisfied with it, so I'm applying a gradiated filter for that side. And again, I'm adding contrast first. And I also increase the highlights. I think I'm doing kind of the same thing for the right side. Just a bit of contrast and a bit of highlights. Now I need to reduce the whites a little bit. Also, I could increase the blacks a tiny bit. Okay, then maybe I need to do some cropping, as I don't like the bottom part of the image. And now for the color correction. I don't want to have a heavy saturated image, so I'm reducing the orange, yellow and green color saturation. And at the same time I want to give the blue color tones a bit more saturation. And for the luminance, I am reducing the blue color luminance. And then I'm increasing the yellow one, but just a little bit. And for the split toning, I want to give my highlights a warmer color look, but I'm not adding strength to it. And for the shadows, I'm going with something colder. Again, I'm reducing the strength of that effect. Okay, now I can go on with the sharpening. Just the usual settings. Oh, I don't know why I always forget to check those two boxes. In the last few videos I did the same thing, but normally I always check those first. Anyway, I want to add some vignetting then. Something like this looks nice. And that's it for the Lightroom part. Now I'm going to export it and fix the remaining problems, like those spots on the image you can see there in Photoshop. Okay, first I want to fix those spots. I think I just use the healing brush tool for that one. Then I might add a little bit of contrast using the Nick Collection filter. And I'm going with the Pro Contrast filter, and I'm just adding some of the correct contrast. And I don't want this effect to be applied on the darker areas of the image, so I'm masking those out. Now I could add some more filters of the Nick Collection, like the polarization filter, but I really don't want to overdo it with this image. But I want to add one last thing. And again, it's some glow in the center of the image. Therefore, I'm applying a new layer, and then I'm picking up a color from the center of the image. And now I'm using a huge brush tool with 0% hardness, and then I just paint right in the center. And all I need to do now is change the blending mode of this layer to soft light, and then reduce the opacity. Also, I could add the same effect on the top right side of the image. Also, I need to crop a little bit more, I think. Okay, that's it for this image. Thank you for watching, and if you'd like to see more content like this, then feel free to subscribe to my channel. And see you next time.